First it was toilet paper, now this. Frenzied shoppers clearing the shelves of fitness equipment.
Business has been booming, absolutely absurd.
Before the pandemic, this Gold Coast warehouse was receiving around 30 orders a day for home gym equipment. Once facilities closed, demand skyrocketed to 30 times that.
We had people lining up out the door, literally throwing money at us.
This Brisbane supplier has experienced a similar surge in customers. The good news is it's brought on more staff.
People are looking to build a mini gym with inside their house, so things like squat cages or pull-up racks.
But people have to wait until June for items they've paid for. Local manufacturers literally can't get the goods out quick enough.
We would probably put a number of around 3,000% increase just on our website alone, let alone phone call inquiries.
Those who missed out are having to get creative, using everyday household items instead.
There's clearly supply and demand taking place. And we've probably seen this a little bit with pricing as well.
That's certainly the case for second-hand equipment. Old, used items are fetching more than new goods online and selling in a matter of minutes.
You can sell them for whatever price you can get them for. And clearly people are willing to pay top dollar for even the very basic gym equipment.
The big source of income, though, for these local manufacturers is supplying and fitting out gyms, while the smaller equipment is a big moneymaker right now. The unknown of whether gyms can financially reopen will impact these businesses into the future.
We'd probably see, realistically, a 50% reduction in our general revenue now that we're no longer doing commercial. So commercial coming on back on board for us is something we want to happen.
Their customers hope so too. Brittany Klein, ABC News.